I want to talk briefly about the concept of dominance. And to do this, I'm going to use some of Mendel's data. And the way that we check to see which allele is dominant and which allele is recessive is entirely empirical. So we have to do an experiment to find out which allele is dominant and which is recessive. And the way we do that is by using strains or types of individuals that are pure breeding. And when we talk about a pure breeding individual, we talk about an individual that's homozygous at every locus that we're looking at. In other words, they only produce offspring when you self them or when you mate two individuals with the same phenotype. They will only produce offspring that all 100% of them have that phenotype. So in Mendel's case, he had a cross where he had peas with purple flowers, and we'll call that the pea gene. And he had a pure breeding plant that produced purple flowers and long pollen. And we don't know if those genes are on the same chromosome or different chromosomes. And every time he selfed one of these plants, because they're self-fertile, they produce 100% of their offspring are purple flowered and have long pollen. So that's a pure breeding genotype. Those should be slashes there too, P over P, L over L. By contrast, he also had little p over little p, let's say little l over little l. Although, when Mendel started this experiment, he didn't know which was dominant and which was recessive. So instead of using little p's and little l's, just for argument's sake, I'm going to call these version 2 of the same allele. So p2 over p2. All he knew at the time that he did these experiments was there was a difference. P1 allele created purple flowers. P2 creates red flowers. And when you have the second allele at the L locus, he got short pollen grains. So the way that we check dominance is simply by crossing these two genotypes together, two pure breeding genotypes, and ask what are the phenotypes in their offspring. So if you look at this case, what you'll get is these parents produce gametes that are only P1, L1 gametes. And because this is a pure breeding genotype, again, produce P2, L2 gametes. So when you combine these together, you get a P1 over P2, L1 over L2, F1 offspring. What Mendel found was that this individual had purple flowers and long pollen grains. And that defined that the P1 gene, or the P1 allele, purple, and the L1 allele that came from this parent, long pollen grains, were dominant. So P1 is dominant to P2. That is, it is, if there are two copies of this gene, two alleles, it's the phenotype or trait that will show up in the offspring. And the same was true for the L1. L1 is dominant to L2. This is the point now when we can bring back capital and lowercase letter concepts. We geneticists typically define that the capital letter is used for the dominant allele, and that we'll use lowercase letters to represent recessive alleles, the alleles whose phenotypes don't show up in the F1. After you cross two pure breeding genotypes. Likewise, long pollen grains, capital L, is dominant to short pollen grains or lowercase l. Lastly, I want to mention that we'll go into class later. We'll do more detail on why alleles are dominant or recessive to each other. I just want to leave you with one simple concept that the recessive allele could often be recessive because it creates a phenotype that's caused by a mutation that results in that version of the gene being broken or inactive. And that's one of the benefits of being a diploid, is that if you're diploid and you have two copies of every gene, if one of them, like a recessive allele, is recessive because it's got a mutation in it, you still have one wild type copy, which is often a dominant version of the allele, to create the normal or wild type trait like purple flowers. So that's just one way in which some alleles can be dominant over others. And there's a benefit to being a diploid individual We have two copies of each gene. If one of them gets disrupted by a mutation or a genetic change, there's a backup version or another copy that we have to produce traits that are wild type.